Hello, welcome back. So as you can see, your character actually changes the way it looks on the ship. Now, you might have seen the pictures for the weapons when I don't know, moused over them or brush over them. And yeah, they're as crazy as you see in the pictures. So don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I actually started the game a couple of times, so if you start your game, you have actually a better chance of getting gear, or sometimes you have a worse chance. I restarted two times, and the first time I restarted, I didn't get as much money and I didn't get any better repair kits, but now I actually got more advanced repair kits and actually a little more money. Me Ogre, me Smash. He hunches back. He's so hunched back, he's almost like a troll at this point, or a troglodyte. Yeah, the weapons are exactly how they look in the little pictures over here, so yeah. Weapons are a little bit silly, but silly and over the top, but I don't know, maybe they fit right in into the game. Huge club. Yep, amazing work. Now, wait, I don't think, okay, let's load the game. I think that only loads my autosave and not my last save game, okay? I had also the building plan and the mallet, which will be used for, you know, to build a base. Oh. Well, I guess this is a pretty good location to build a base. Near our friend. Well, good thing he cannot damage you, and we also have a source of fiber, and okay, this is a pretty good position. So let's see, does it snap on? Not really, doesn't snap on. Oh, it does snap on, but under certain circumstances, okay. It's a little bit finicky. Well, I guess it works. Now, the game wants me to build a ramp, which is also called a staircase in other languages. Okay, let's see. So it wants me to build 6 ceilings. Okay, that means I need more foundations. To be honest, you actually need a lot of wood to build this. And it seems like I'm kind of wasting my area or preventing resources from spawning in the area that there is my base. Now my question would be, why do you need wolves? What happens if you don't have wolves? What kind of a creature attacks you? Do we have windows? I think we have windows. Can we just build window frames all over the place? Probably. Why is the music so low? I mean, okay, game, don't be finicky. Okay, now we just need the door frame. Well, it says ceiling, so I guess it's ceiling and not roof. I guess I run out of wood. Okay, let's get a little more wood and then finish the little house we have. I mean, the game is extremely well made for what it is right now. Yes, it needs a little more polish and you know, a few things here and there. Some bubblegum, some super glue. Just hold all of it together, but for now it's pretty interesting. Also, we didn't even see the combat yet, which is a little weird, but again, it kind of works with the game's theme. The only thing I don't like about the game currently is that it's a little hard. For example, you have to be very on point with your cursor to get an item. As you can see, it's almost pixel perfect. I don't know why it's like that. So that basically means you have to stop moving and actually aim your cursor at the thing you want to pick up. Which is a little unnecessary in my opinion, because it slows down the game a lot. Especially when you're building stuff. So, if you're wondering why do we have so much ROM, well, it's a healing item, probably. So you want more of those, of course. So yeah, they give you repair kits, healing items, and water. And the food you can get from the beach over here. Totem door, simple door lock. Well, to be honest, the game is a multiplayer game, and remember, it might not be one of those survival multiplayer PvP games, but you can still PvP in the game from what I learned. I mean, from what I read on the forums, the game has a PvP element to it as well, so even though you can make dedicated servers, I think other people can join you and they can destroy your stuff or stuff like that. I'm not sure of all of the details right now. But it's like one of those survival games where people can enter your base, steal all of your stuff, and then you can cry, and then you can leave the game and come back tomorrow. And farm all over again. I don't know, we'll have to see where the game goes, because when you have a game with so much potential, it can go anywhere. It can go from the worst game in the world to the best game in the world in probably days. Also, it's a bit slower to gather the wood, so yeah. Remember when I said when I started playing the game that finally a survival game that doesn't make you chop wood for 100 hours? Well, I was wrong. It will make you chop wood for 100 hours. So let's eat all of the crab meat, because apparently we are very hungry. So to get the full benefits, you have to wait 10 seconds. Okay, you can wait 10 seconds. I also feel like you're getting a lot more palm leaves and coconuts than wood. Well, do you need a complete ceiling or do you need to continue the quest? I guess we'll continue the quest today because I want to finish it. I guess I got the meat from a rat I picked up. I guess you have a pretty... pretty interesting tutorial, so let's see. The door arrow, the door's way... Totem. Oh man, they really make you chop down so much wood. Okay, let's go back to chopping wood, because that's our main job in this game. Yeah, it looks like we have to use that nice system of door locks and land claims. Now, that makes me wonder, will the game ever have a big server where a lot of people can play on it? Because if the game will have big servers where many people can play on it and they can also PvP, that's actually a plus for me. I mean, I'm not really big into the whole PvP survival game because most of the times they're done very, very badly. But if they do it right and they make it fun and they make it challenging, and also they kind of keep it fair, oh, then I'm more interested in the game right now. Ah, yes. That beautiful volcano would be nice to explore. If I had enough food. Also, I don't understand what happened with the day and night cycle, because apparently when I reloaded my game, the day and night cycle broke a little bit and now it's day again. Well, that might be useful. I have to try it again, or maybe it was not late enough for the night to come. I'll have to try. So over there we have a beach with a lighthouse, over there we have a castle, and over there we have probably an active volcano from what it seems like. I wish you would get all of the stuff all of the stuff that falls from your tree directly in your inventory, because this is a bit ridiculous. You cannot queue an item and then craft another item, you just need to wait for... Ah, whatever. Give me 10 of the cloths. Yeah, it's starting to, you know, lose its attraction on me. I mean, survival games need to kind of step away from the woodcutting mechanics a lot. Yeah, you can use something to repair it. But I also want to test out what happens if you just throw it away and make a new one. Survival game need to step away from the absurd amount of farming time you need to play the game. They just needed to make it a little more convenient for you. I mean, not exactly everything, but you know, they could give all of the items you get from the tree into an inventory at least. Because like I said, it's super hard to pick up everything because of the pixel perfect thing you have to do. I'm not sure we'll need the coconuts, they'll spoil anyway, but let's just get all of them for safety reasons. Spoil coconut, okay, I guess they can spoil as well. Okay, so we have a door. We have a lock on the door. Yeah, this makes me worried. Let's have two doors. Now what about that totem? I think we can leave the roof as it is right now because it creates a lot of light. And I like to have a lot of light in my house. I don't know why it works like that, authorize and deauthorize. Bed and chest and workbench, okay. Well, I guess I should have prepared for this. Looks like we'll have a very long episode of me cutting a lot of wood. Well, I guess that's not a problem. And there I went, thinking we will not have to cut a lot of wood. I mean, the first time I played the game, so I got a lot of wood from the chest, so I think that amount of wood would have been would have been enough. But looks like the second time, or actually the third time I restarted the game, I didn't get a lot of wood. Which is kind of counterproductive, to be honest. Oh, you can destroy the stumps as well. Well, I don't remember the game telling me that. Okay, so let's destroy the stumps as well. Maybe that's why the trees don't grow back. Or maybe if you destroy the stumps, the trees won't grow back. Eh, a lot of the elements. Let's just destroy it. Anyway, the game is pretty interesting. From what I saw from the other screenshots and videos for the game, you're actually going to fight a lot of enemies and the game will get a lot harder. So the PvP elements of the game are pretty interesting as well. I guess most people will be interested in the co-op version of the game, but to be honest, it's... Well, this game is basically early access. With a lot of, with a lot of extra content, but also with a lot of other mechanics that are not currently working as intended. Sorry about that. And also need to find out where the next source of materials is, which is iron, which will probably unlock stuff for us. Okay, and after this, I'll just go explore the island a bit, because I'm tired of, you know, crafting, as they call it over here. I guess they should make it so you get a lot more wood. By the way, this is a little bug over here. Interesting and scary at the same time. They should make it so you get a lot more wood automatically, because... Okay, let's make the bed and then we'll go, because we might need it to respawn over here. Wow, you need to hit it a lot of times, but you do get 5 wood. I think I'll have enough for the bed after this one. And the chest is... Okay, let's make the chest as well. I mean, we have enough wood. And there I was thinking I was prepared for the video. Nope, I was not really prepared. Another little thing I like about the game is that the little rats actually have a pretty decent AI. They just walk around the place and look at you and look at other people. It does make the game feel a little more alive, you know, if a game doesn't have any animals or anything that moves, it tends to be more on the, I don't know, boring side. Probably can cut down trees with any item or any weapon in the game, but the axe will always be the fastest one. Okay, a few hits didn't register over there. It's okay. Okay, 5 more wood. We can do that. Okay, looks like night time is really coming in. The game does look more beautiful sometimes. Based on the light. I wonder what you get for finishing the tutorial, so I guess you'll get something for finishing the tutorial, so that's why I'm doing it right now. Yes, floor and rats, the main component of any island. I'll just collect more of the red plants, because I assume there'll be healing potions later. Well, this is annoying. It's so dark I cannot see anything. Okay, we have new recipes over here. A lot of new recipes, actually. Okay, so this is where we can do the iron stuff. If I actually had the okay, if I actually had the fiber for it. Well, by the power of, let's see, by the power of using filters, I will increase the gamma. Well, that seems decent. We can see most things. I mean, you can see most things. I'm still pretty blind over here. Yeah, so let's craft that torch. Oh, it needs a sharp stone as well. Well, okay. This is getting annoying. Why is it? Why don't it? It should show me the same list as before. I mean, this list is a lot bigger, so I can see a lot of. Wait. Did the game bug out or what happened? I need one more piece of wood. You gotta be joking me! Wow, this is annoying with the wood. Okay, I need to farm a lot of wood. Probably, okay. Actually, I probably need to get the iron tools because this is so slow. It will be ridiculous. And they also need to decrease the crafting timers. I don't know why you have crafting timers that are so long in a game like this. It's basically a single player game. It should be instant. Okay, it actually is a lot better than I expected. Oh, 5 wood, okay. Okay, I get it. I need more wood. Looks like the exploration for today was cancelled due to a lack of wood. A concerning lack of wood, actually. I guess the shovel is used to get clay. Don't worry, I'm a professional lumberjack, so I can do anything in the dark. Yeah, I think they should give you about 200 wood and call it a day. Here's 200 wood in a chest, do whatever you want with it. And nobody would say they're angry about it. Also looks like coconuts are not the best survival food, or at least not in this game. Looks like I have to eat quite a bit to actually maintain the stats, where I have to eat, well, basic resources will always restore less than the other ones, probably. Stone, flint, wood, clay. What I remember, clay is in the water. In the dark areas of the water, or any, doesn't really matter. Let's just go and explore the island. Or at least the lighthouse. Now, from what I remember, clay is in the dark areas near the water. Probably not everywhere on the world, so I guess we do have to do some exploring. Please tell me I can go inside the lighthouse. Okay, this makes things a little easier. But I don't see 200 wood. Okay, game, looks like it makes me exercise a lot. That's all there is over here in the lighthouse. Oh! Just a lot of skeletons hanging around. Okay, now that made it. That made it worth it. I also got a little bit of wood. Let's throw away the sand, because it looks like we can get a lot of it. Also, my carry limit is pretty generous, to be honest. Okay, I don't want to make the video too long, but I guess we can explore for a few more minutes, because we did a lot of wood chopping over there, and we also saw the day and night cycle. Also, the tutorial seems pretty long for what it is, and I guess I still have to do a lot of crafting. Well, one jar, two dirty water. I guess we'll have to take the water for now. Remember, the game is not fully functioning, so all of the features are not implemented. So I assume later it will be probably a lot harder to get water. I guess you can just eat coconuts and take a little midnight stroll on the beach. Happy rats all over the place, no one will make them burgers. What? I don't know, something fell out of me or... Okay, so how do you use the repair kits? Drag and drop, it is very easy. I guess near that evil looking tree or the dried up tree we'll find resources. Also, before we go any further, let's just save the game. I don't really trust the autosave function. The game is pretty quiet at night. Yeah, now we look more menacing. I hate the artificial walls. Oh wow, it's so dark over here. On the other hand, does this area have clay? Yeah, this area has clay. Okay. I guess I read on the forum somewhere you could get it out of the... I don't know, maybe I'm just imagining things. Probably the flint was in near the water in the dark areas. Also, this is super, super dark. Okay, we have achieved flint. Oh, okay, so this is the real night. I mean, until now it was a bit bright, but now it's actually pitch black. You cannot do anything in the dark like that. And to be honest, not even the game on your computer will help you with this one, because it's just complete darkness. Kind of scary if you think about it. I mean, you do have a map, and this is why you don't travel around in the night. Okay, let's respawn. I think you lose everything if you die. I'm not sure about that. Yeah, you lose everything. Let's respawn and let's reload the game. Let's see if it works like that. Yeah, I'll not do that all over again. I'll just have to reload the game and get the clay, get a lot of clay, and then just see you again in the next episode, where I'll have, first of all, a lot of wood, and secondly, I'll have a lot of resources other than wood. Yeah, reloading the game resets the den. Oh, that's scary. Okay, so reloading the game does reset the day and night cycle, which is great. And probably in the other episode, in the next episode, like I said, we'll just have to explore that camp over there, that ship over there, and probably build a lot more stuff in our base. Well, see you next time. Bye.